Welcome to all of you. Myself Niranjan Jena, Faculty Department of Civil Engineering, Jharsuguda Indian School, Jharsuguda. So today we discuss your new topic, the disposition of points. In the engineering training already we have covered the first chapter and the second chapter, the types of scale, plane scale, diagonal scale. On this chapter, projection of point, we will discuss what is the location of a point with respect to our quadrant. So first, what do you mean by projection? Projection means representation of an object on a 2D plane. I am representing the object on this blackboard, so this is known as projection. The projection of an object means representation of an object on a 2D plane. If you represent something on a 2D plane, that is known as projection. Then meaning of points. So there is two definitions. Point, this is the figure of a point. So how can you define in the engineering term? So first, the point is a line having zero length. And the second point, a circle having zero diameter. In these two ways, you can define a point. Suppose it's a circle. It has some specific diameter. If you reduce it, then again it will be a small circle. If again you reduce, it will be a small circle. Again you reduce, it looks like a point. So when you minimize the diameter, a circle becomes a point. So it's a circle having zero diameter. Next, line having zero length. So now check. This is the length. Suppose the length is 10 cm. When you reduce it to 8 cm, 5 cm, 3 cm, 2 cm, 1 cm, 0 cm. When you reduce the length, then the final reduction, the last reduction is a point. So this is the definition of point. You can define in these two ways. A circle having zero diameter or a line having zero length. So I think the projection and the point word is clear to all of you. First, projection means representing something on a plane. And point, it's have no dimension. The dimension is zero, length equal to zero. It has no diameter. So now move to the important terminology. What are the terms used in this chapter? HP, horizontal plane. Next one we'll use with you. In the, these two terms will be frequently used in the engineering. Projection of point chapter, projection of plane, projection of solid. You will use HP and VP. What is the meaning of HP? Horizontal plane. VP, vertical plane. P stands for plane, H stands for horizontal, V stands for vertical. Next, how can we define which one is horizontal plane, which one is vertical plane? Let's take the example. In this building, this blackboard is a vertical plane in front of your view. Vertical plane means the plane which is in front. This is the front view. Vertical plane is the front view. Now the question is, what does mean is horizontal plane? This is the top view. If you see the object downward like this, then you can see the horizontal plane. Here is the vertical plane front view and here is the horizontal plane top view. I think this two plane is clear. If you represent graphically, one is horizontal plane, another one is vertical plane. And both are mutually perpendicular to each other. The angle between them is 90 degrees. Both are mutually perpendicular. Horizontal plane is the top view. How can you see the object? In up to down. Then I can see the floor of this building. Example, floor. And front view, vertical is blackboard, this wall.
See, this term is clear to all of you. First one, what is horizontal plane? What is vertical plane? And the both are mutually perpendicular. In front view, you can see vertical plane. Like your projector, movie theater, this backboard. The object which is in front of you, that is known as VP plane. HP, that is a top view. And top view is sometimes called plan. Sometimes we call it the plan of the object, the top view. So now we discuss the quadrants. Number of quadrants is 4. There is 4 quadrants. According to the position of point, there is 4 quadrants. So how can you guess there is a 4 quadrant? How can you know? So here I will explain. One important thing, how can you numberize this quadrants? So always number the quadrants in anti-clockwise place. Not clockwise, it is anti-clockwise. Opposite of the clock. Quadrant 1, 2, 3, 4. This symbol will be anti-clockwise. You should remember the quadrants. How can you draw the quadrants in anti-clockwise direction? If you draw the clockwise direction, then the whole question will be wrong. Because your points and this projection is depends upon the plane, horizontal plane, vertical plane. If you draw the reverse case, then you will get the 0 mark. So first you know, the quadrant will be marking is the anti-clockwise case. Next, there is only 4 what to remember this quadrant. How can you do it? Suppose I will take a point A. And this is my AP line, horizontal plane. This is vertical plane, already I have discussed horizontal and vertical. So now you can say A point is above HP. Point A is above HP. So you can write up above. And in front of BP. Above HP, in front of BP. Now take the another point B. So now you can check same. B point is above HP. B point is same above HP. But it is not in front. The portion which is on my left hand side, this side, is the in front. And the back side is behind. Just opposite what? In front, behind. Above, below. So here, it will be behind. Next, you check just opposite point number C. You can check it is below the HP. The point is below the HP. So you can write down. Below the point C, which is below the HP line. This is your reference line, HP. The point is below the HP line. Next, behind. This side portion is behind, and front side is in front. And the top portion is above, bottom portion is below. Simple forward. So it is behind. Next, point number D. This point. Below HP. And where is the location? In front of VP. And there is also a trick. If you just remember the mode 2 quadrant, then easily you can remember the 4. 1 and 3, both are opposite. Above, below. In front, behind. It's the opposite game. 2 and 4, both are opposite. You can check above. Below, behind, in front. So if you remember just 2 quadrants, first and third, then second and fourth will be opposite. First opposite third, second opposite fourth. So here is the figure. Your question that is directly they will ask based upon this principle. 20 mark question under 8 is an exam. This is directly based upon this principle. A point which is given above or below, in front, like this, they mix the question. And you can first find out it is in which quadrant. Next, you can solve the question on your brain. I think this concept is clear. So HP line, the portion is above. HP line, the portion is below. Next, VP line, this is the vertical line. This side is in front and back side is behind. So next, we move to a question. I will write the question here. A point 30 mm 3.8, which is 30 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of BP. This is the given question. A point A which is 30 mm above HP and 20 mm in front of BP. Draw the projection of that. Like question you will get in your practical ED examination. 20 mark question, there is nothing to worry. First you check in which quadrant, next you just draw the xy reference, then show the point. It's a very easy question from this chapter. Then how can you solve this question? Your first duty is check the quadrant. So now you can check here. Above HP and in front of VP. In which quadrant? Above HP, in front of VP. That is in first quadrant, quadrant number 1. So here I will give the solution, take the solution. First, you draw a reference line x and y. You draw a reference line x, y. Now your duty is which plane is HP and which plane is VP. In the projection of points, you don't move the vertical plane because vertical plane is fixed. There is nothing to change in the vertical plane. You rotate your horizontal plane in clockwise. So now just take in this quadrant, this is the vertical plane, this is the horizontal plane, definitely VP. If you rotate this horizontal plane, so let's mark in my here. If you rotate this horizontal plane, this HP point will be in downward side. Just like this. Suppose mark the white color in this cluster. This is HP. If you rotate it horizontal plane, then HP on the downward side. Same. So now it's here. VP upper, HP niche. So now we can write here VP. Yes, because when you rotate the plane, then HP will be on the downward side. So here is the VP, here is the HP. Next step, you should found how much mm above. Now from this figure it is clear, the bottom portion is the horizontal plane. Below the line, up to the ground level, jitna bhi niche ja sakte, that is known as horizontal plane. And above this line is the vertical plane. So how much mm above? 30 mm above HP. That means from this plane a point which is 30 mm above HP. So now we can draw the 30 mm. 30 mm from the reference line above HP. So here is the point. Next 30 mm part is over. The point is how much mm above HP? 30 mm. 30 mm upper. Then 20 mm in front of BP. From this BP plane, how much mm in front? 20 mm. From the same line you can draw downward. 20 mm. There is a point. The point which is 30 mm above HP, 20 mm in front of BP. So just around these two points. Next, show the error mark. So your error ratio is 1:3. In the already scale chapter already I have studied. Error is 1:3 ratio. So you can show here. So it is 30 mm above HP, 20 mm in front of BP. Now check, the question is given in capital A, it is capital A. But when you represent on the drawing sheet, it will be small a, small a. So let's say this is point A, point A. But there is also an important term. In vertical plane, always the point with dash. A dash. This is the important. If you have done this whole thing on your exam sheet or your answer sheet, definitely you will get 20 marks. There is no deduction because first function, you draw a reference line x and y. Next, check which one is BP, which one is HP. Constant which one is BP because there is no changes in BP plane. You just rotate your HP. When you rotate, this HP will be downside. Like this cross mark. Suppose HP on this side, if you rotate it, HP on downside. Same, BP upper, HP each. Next, the point A which is 30 mm above HP. From the horizontal plane, it is 30 mm above. So this is A. 20 mm in front. 20 mm in front. So now I can check horizontal plane mein a simple small a on the vertical plane a dash. This is the concept. If you have done this most thing and you see directly you get 20 marks. So I will give some questions on my notes section, you can solve it. When I just explain for this first question, then how can you the second, third and fourth part in any? Next above is मतलब ऊपर below मतलब नीचे होगा. वो above below का concept है. ये जो VPHP हमेशा change होगा. First part and second, third, fourth the same नहीं है. ये VPHP HP भी हो सकता है. VPHP एक साथ भी हो सकता है. नीचे भी हो सकता है. So I will discuss that point. For quadrant 1, VP ऊपर HP नीचे. Same for quadrant 2. Second quadrant. Same to draw XY. Next concept. You can check on the quadrant 2. On this quadrant, VP upper HP on this side. This is HP, this is VP for the second quadrant. Same concept. You mark here, this point is HP point, this cross mark, HP. If you rotate in clockwise direction, then HP will be on the upper side. So both HP and VP on the offside. Again, check the concept. This is the HP point, cross mark. If you rotate it, then HP and VP both will be on offside. So here is the HP. HP and VP both in the top side. In the third quadrant, it is the opposite. First and third opposite. So VP, HP will be reverse. HP and VP. In the fourth quadrant, second and fourth opposite. So here VP, HP both are in one side, outside, it will be downside. Like this way, you can solve your question. So I will send some question on my comment section or post some question in comment section. Otherwise, you can practice the question from the standard book. If you have any doubt, you can comment on the comment section. Thank you. All of you.